do you see excesses in the markets?
Well, I mentioned it earlier at the outset of the show. I think it's still the bond market, but that's precisely a feature of financial repression. And I think the markets aren't repricing risk. It's quite interesting. We had an initial rise in the yield curve, a steepening in the yield curve a few weeks back. And then the central banks came in very clearly, the Fed and then the ECB, saying, well, not so fast. You know, we want to stay well in control of this. We don't want an unorderly unraveling of our QE policies, and therefore markets have taken heed and, you know, hit new highs, and, you know, yield curves are flattened again.
Are you worried that there's too much dry powder out there? Capital has been raised but not been deployed, and is this the right time to take risk?
You know, we've seen the charts. Equities are at an all-time high. You know, bond yields are very, very low or negative, depending on where on the yield curve you are. So is this the time to take risk? No. But is this a time to take some risk if you haven't taken any risk already? Yes, it is, because this is what you need to do today. Now, if you're already long the market, the equity market, you know, would you want to add at this point? Probably not. But, you know, it depends on where you're positioned and your risk profile to date.
What is Governor Carney going to do? I mean, I know we're talking central banks here. I was stunned last time as Carney did the ballet on inflation. The sterling wasn't at 132.50 the last time Mr. Carney spoke on this. What is Carney going to do? I want an answer.
I think he's going to explain the inflation rate away and point towards the underlying inflation rate and therefore leave current policy rates.
Fascinating.
Particularly, I don't think he wants sterling to rise against the euro as well, because we talked about cable, but, you know, against the euro, you know, sterling hasn't really been strong over the past 2 or 3 months, and I think it's more a case of dollar weakness against sterling than it is of sterling strength. But you don't want this inflation result suddenly to lead to all-out weighted sterling strength. That would make the task for the UK economy and this Brexit uncertainty even more difficult.
Francine.